Welcome to episode 52 of My Views Extended. I'm your host, Nadia, and thank you so much for joining me this week. If you are a return listener, thank you so much for coming back. And if you are a new listener, thank you so much for tuning in to My Views Extended. You can listen to My Views Extended on my blog at nadiadanella.com or on YouTube, where closed captioning is available for those who need it. My YouTube channel name is Nadia Danella, NadiaDonella. Your shares, your views, and your likes are very much appreciated, and they help to grow this channel. Sign up is free on the YouTube channel, and it just takes a couple minutes to subscribe and click that notification button. I believe it's in the right hand corner, so you know when I upload a new podcast, or you can just go directly to my blog and listen to it there, nadiadanella.com. If you have any questions, concerns, or business inquiries, you can contact me at myviewsextended@gmail.com. And I will get back to you as soon as possible. And as always, I will leave links to all social media sites in the show notes and description boxes. I'm not really sure if this is going to be the last episode of My Views Extended for 2016 yet. Probably not. We'll see. I'm tired. It's been a long year, a really long year. All my years are long, it seems, but this year has been particularly hard or longer, more tiring, you know, because I don't have other distractions like family issues or school or anything else. So I'm very much focused on what I'm doing. And, you know, like anything, when you're trying to start a new business, you're just busy. That's just the nature of starting something from scratch. So anyway, I'll do my best to continue to put out content for the rest of 2016, but we'll see. But I'm so looking forward to my week in January. Like I said, unless something really spectacular happens from January 1st to January 7th, I am doing not a darn thing. If I want to sit on the couch and pick my belly button lint all day long, that is exactly what I'm going to do. I would love to go away for a few days, but the finances are not there right now. Hopefully I will say, speak it into existence that in 2017 at some point in the year, hopefully not all the way at the end of the year, but in some point I'll be able to get away for at least a few days for some rest and relaxation. I don't know where, but it's going to happen. So yeah, I cannot wait for my week to do absolutely nothing work related. Even if I want to, I'm not going to do it because I need that time for my mental health. And it's good for you. Everybody deserves some time off, even for the crazy workaholics like myself. Anyway, the snow continues here on the lower mainland. It's not crazy amounts like, you know, people are used to getting around the rest of the country or in the northern parts of BC, but you know, most of the suburbs in the lower mainland of BC don't even have snow plows. You just see a truck with a blade attached, and to say that they're ill prepared is an understatement. It's interesting, but things are just slower, a lot of cancellations, delays, you know, when it comes to public transportation. When you look at the streets, because most where I live, it's mostly condos, townhouses, you see the cars parked along the street and they are literally snowed, and these cars haven't even attempted to take them out. They're just like a foot or more of snow, and all the snow is plowed around the tires. They haven't even tried to pull them out. So it's kind of funny how everything just seems to shut down. But again, I'm assuming that those are a lot of older people. And you know, if you don't have to go out, and then don't, if you're not used to this weather, and or even if you don't have the proper walking shoes, there's no sense in going out in there and risking breaking a bone or smashing your head in the end of your car. Yeah, but I think a lot of these cities in here, in the lower mainland, are going to have to invest in snow plows, because I truly believe in the upcoming years, you know, in places where snow is not common, it's going to become more common, you know, as the climate change continues and as time passes. It's not just going to be every 3 or 4 or 5 years where they get snow. I think it's going to start being in the next few years, it's going to be every year that they're going to have snow, and that's just going to have to be worked into the budget of these cities around the world that don't get snow on a regular basis, but now are seeing snow in the last several years on a regular basis. But I was happy to hear my snowplow, not a snowplow, a truck with a blade on it. My side street was plowed. I was shocked, but I think, are we in week 2 or 3? I can't remember. week two of snow. Yeah, so I guess they had to, somebody had to, whether it was a city or a private company, somebody had to break into the budget and get that plowed out, because people can't continue to just, you can't stop life for, what is it, 2 weeks now? You have to, life has to go on. You can't snow. If it's a couple of days, that's one thing, but you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, people have to get going. So you have to plow people out. Anyway, hopefully with the more side streets being plowed, that'll help people get out a little more safely when they have to venture out into the crazy Christmas world of holiday time. Yeah. I started listening to Christmas music this last weekend and it was nice. It's nice. I'm still trying to find a really good Christmas movie to watch. I think I might have to just, because I was looking on Netflix and I can't remember someplace else for Christmas movies and I wasn't too impressed, so I think I'm just gonna have to go into my own personal collection of movies. But I did anyway, like I was saying, I started listening to Christmas music last week and it was so nice. And although I do sing Christmas music throughout the year, usually in the summer when it's really really hot, I tend to sing Christmas music. But anyway, yeah, so it was nice. Mind you, I love Christmas music, but some of them are so sad and melancholy, but I still love it. To say my favorite Christmas songs, not in any particular order, are definitely, let's see, Oh Holy Night. I like Celine Dion version. That's one of my favorite versions. The Little Drummer Boy, Silent Night, Ava Maria. That's just a few. And I definitely like the traditional versions of most of the songs, like, you know, the Bing Crosby, Nat King Cole versions. I'm not a fan of the rock, rap, or reggae versions. Sorry, but that's just not my thing. Everybody has a personal preference. Yeah, what are your favorite Christmas tunes? And when do you start playing them? Do you start playing them like a month ahead of time? Do you play them throughout the year? Or do you just like a week before Christmas? And also, oh yeah, and favorite movie, I started saying that. Probably most versions of A Christmas Carol. It's a real, again, kind of melancholy, depressing movie, but I still like them. I like the animated versions and the live action versions. I just really, I've always, since I was a little kid, I've always loved them. I don't know why. So yeah, I'd love to hear your favorite Christmas tunes and favorite Christmas movies. Drop them in the comment section below so I can see what you're listening to and what you like to watch. I was pretty psyched last week because I didn't do a podcast last week, but I still wanted to mention this. It was really cool because, you know, Black Girl Magic, we are doctors too, #. A Black female chemistry professor was awarded $324,000 from the National Institute of Justice to study rape investigation methods. And I thought this was awesome because she's female, she's Black, and she's smart, and because chemistry is hard as blank, at least from my perspective. Chemistry, I tried. Oh boy, I tried, but chemistry eluded me when it came to the sciences. I think the only thing that I kind of did halfway decent at was physics, which surprised the heck out of me when I actually understood it. But yeah, chemistry, biology, oh no, biochem, mm-mm. Anyway, her research, and her meaning Dr. Candace Bridge, her research could bring about a unique new means of identifying perpetrators of sexual assault when traditional DNA evidence doesn't exist. According to Dr. Bridge, because rapists try to remove or keep any DNA evidence, this research will help to develop new forensic science techniques to aid in sexual assault investigations. And I'll just continue to quote her the next part to give you a better idea of what her research will entail. Dr. Bridge will be working with instrumentation currently only available to the FBI and a limited number of federal and state forensic laboratories to investigate ways to identify rapists by means other than DNA evidence. Bridge works alongside her research group of 11 students that investigate lubricants used in sexual assault, in addition to research in the areas of drugs, toxicology, and gunshot residue. Dr. Candace Bridge, PhD, I might add, is currently the first Black female to teach at the University of Central Florida. I'm just personally, like I said, I'm thrilled at anyone who excels in the sciences. I think it's great for women, it's great for women of color, and most importantly, hopefully her research will help the victims of sexual assault, help bring their perpetrators to justice, and help with their eventual healing from their assault. And that is, I'll leave the links to The Root and to sbwire.com so you can read a little bit more about Dr. Candace Bridge and her research study. Another interesting thing I saw was about human evolution. Can the high rate of cesarean births affect human evolution? And this is from bbc.com and from pnas.org, and I'll leave the links below. the theory by the researchers from Austria are that they have found cases where the baby cannot fit down the birth canal have increased from 30 to 1,000 births in the 1960s to today, 36 and 1,000 births. Without modern medical intervention, such problems often were lethal, and this is from an evolutionary perspective selection. Women with a very narrow pelvis could not have survived birth 100 years ago. They do now because of cesareans and pass on their gene encoding for a narrow pelvis to their daughters. And of course, there's always two sides or three sides to the story. The other side of the theory in research states that larger newborns are occurring not because of narrower pelvises, but because they're more healthy. Better nutrition, access to better healthcare throughout the pregnancy. So that just means the babies are bigger than they were 50, 60 years ago. But there's no need to worry. Most of us will still come into the world via the birth canal. And for those who do have issues with the right medical intervention, we can deliver healthy children and of course have a healthy and alive mother. Both theories are very interesting and very plausible. And usually evolution doesn't move quite so quickly, but in this case it seems to be doing so. And again, I'll leave links to those articles in the show notes. Quote or saying of the week, pretty simple this week: friendship is like peeing on yourself. Everyone can see it, but only you get the warm feeling that it brings. Robert Bloch. Now that was just funny. Nothing more, nothing less. Did you imagine peeing on yourself, or was it just me? Friendship is like peeing on yourself. Everyone can see it, but only you get the warm feeling that it brings. What I'm grateful for this past week or 2 month, year, I'm grateful for continuing to manage and cope with the upcoming holidays and with the wrapping up of 2016. So I guess it's two things I'm grateful for this past week. I made it through Thanksgiving, which our Canada was in October. And I mean, really, what else was I going to do? You just cope with them the best that you can with the resources that you have. Resources meaning family, pretty much. I've had moments of missing my family back east, especially even more so with the upcoming Christmas holiday. And then right after that, the next week, New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. But like I said, you keep going. It's lonely sometimes, but I have to remind myself that I can only decide if I'm going to be happy or if I'm going to be miserable. What I wish isn't going to happen, nor what I want it to happen. So I just have to live with what I have and with the decisions that I've made. Some of those things, including being across the country from the branch of the family that I grew up with, that, you know, you have those memories with. I am going to cook and play music and remember the best of the Christmases that I had from when my mom was alive and the New Year's when she was alive. And if I'm sad, I'm not going to deny those feelings. I will live them, but not dwell in them. So for me, that is definitely the sanest thing to do. I've decided that I'm going to do, actually my sister, I was like, well, you decide what you want to do. So she and I decided that we're going to do a Christmas lunch this year instead of a Christmas dinner. And I think my best friend is coming over. I hope she's still coming over for Christmas lunch. And I still have no idea what I'm going to be making yet. I did get my wine though. I think green beans. I think I might make a duck breast, but that's about it. I need to have some more vegetarian options and vegan options for my sister and my best friend. But I want it to be tasty. I just don't know yet. I'll figure it out. Oh yeah, I also made my first gingerbread house this past Sunday from scratch. It's not the prettiest gingerbread house on the block, but I like it. And I was just thinking when I decided to make it a couple days before that, I was looking at wait a second, we've never made a gingerbread house before. And so I literally the next or 2 days later or whatever decided to make it and put it together. And yeah, so I think I might do that every year. Like, we'll see, like I'm gonna put it up and see if it can, and box it up and put it up. So we'll see when I pull it out of the box next year if it held up or not. And if not, I'll just make another one. But yeah, it was fun. I really wish that I had done that from when I was a kid. It's a really fun tradition. It was really enjoyable. So we'll see. I was gonna say something else and I can't remember what it was. My memory is shot, by the way. Yeah, what the heck was I gonna say? I don't know. I was gonna say something else, but it's gone. So yeah, dinner, music, probably watch lots of Christmas movies. I found a little thing. I think it was on Netflix. I saw because we don't have a fireplace anymore. Oh, I miss having a house. Anyway, there's like a thing on net or not Netflix, on YouTube, I think it is, and you can pull up a screen on your TV and play, have a little fireplace going on for ambiance and have the Christmas tree lit up. It's gonna be good. So yeah, I'm just grateful for memories and feelings, and whether those feelings are sad or happy, and just happy to be alive and experiencing these human emotions and feelings, and just having experiences like building my first gingerbread house. And you know, I want to make new memories. Like, I don't, none of us really know. We may have ideas, but none of us really know where life is going to take us. But if an opportunity comes up, or if I have an idea or something that I've always wanted to do, I'm just going to go ahead and do it. And if it's as small as building a gingerbread house, or as big as, I don't know, not that I don't know, climbing Mount Everest. I don't want to climb Mount Everest. I'm just saying something grand. If it's something like that and I have the opportunity to do it, I'm gonna do it. And life is short, man. Like, I know I can't be the only one who's like, you look at when you get to a certain point in your adulthood and you're like, every year just is just flying by, and it just seems like every year it's flying by so quickly. I'm like, it was just January and now it's already the end of December, and it's like, no matter how hard you plan, well, for me anyways, no matter how hard I plan, coordinate, there's just not enough time in the day, there's not enough time in a week. And I don't know, I think you just prioritize what's important, what is going to get you from point A to B, focus on that and just do it, sort of. I mean, there's a lot more into that. Anyway, I'm just blathering on, so I don't know. I'm just blathering. I'm just tired and I need a vacation or a break, and there's a lot of things to come in 2017, and the fruits of the labor. 2017 is the fruits of the labor. I'm putting it into the atmosphere. Fruits of the labor. I'd love to hear what you're grateful for, whether it's just this past week or the past year of 2016. Drop it in the comment section below. Let's have a discussion, or just drop it and just share what you're grateful for. Thank you so much for tuning in to episode 52 of My Views Extended. I would love to hear feedback and comments of what you think of this podcast and of the topics that I've discussed this week. You can drop your questions or opinions respectfully in the comment section below. You can listen to My Views Extended at NadiaDonnell.com or on YouTube, where you can subscribe, like, rate, and or leave a comment, and where closed captioning is available. I will leave links in the show notes, and as more listening platforms are added or changed, I will let you know. Till next time, this is Nadia.